Hello everyone. It's so good to see you. Welcome back to Painting at Home. I am Jean Moss. I hope everyone had a safe weekend. I don't get out much, but I do pay a lot of attention to my Google. And I know it's been a very difficult weekend for a lot of people, and also a very empowering weekend. So today I thought it would be a wonderful idea to explore trees. And I tell you why, because I know that I love drawing trees, and I talk about it a lot on my show. Today is going to be a very special tree because we're going to focus on a little bit of symbolism. Now, for those of you who don't know, symbolism is just simply something that stands or means something else. There's a very, very, very accurate definition on Google. I recommend if you're not sure what symbolism means, just look it up. Very, very simple. So today we're going to zoom in on the trees. Now, sometimes they appear in the background of my paintings. Sometimes they are a focus, but they're surrounded by other things. Today, we're just going to focus on the tree. So I'm going to have a sip of my coffee, and we're going to focus on the tree, but also what a tree may symbolize. And I invite you to listen to whatever music feels calming to you. I've picked my jazz station on Pandora. And, you know, pull up a paper or two. Who knows? I've got four here. Pick your favorite materials to paint with and find a way to just incorporate your own symbolism into your tree today. So let's go ahead and give that a go. So I've got my paints here today. I've got lots of new options. And I've got, of course, my friendly brushes. We've got big old Jimmy here, and then I have little Gus. So let's go ahead and get started. Now, I am going to start with little Gus today. I might embark on some other materials as well, but I always like to start with watercolor because it's just so versatile. So I'm going to start with a little bit of brown. Now, I've decided, because this was a big sort of theme in my bigger family, I have 14 brothers and sisters, but this, including, of course, Joni, whom we've all met, we had to focus a lot on keeping the peace. So my tree is going to symbolize peace today, but yours can symbolize whatever you want to. So first, I'm going to just go ahead and start with very simple, just a trunk, but I'm going to just draw up, just drawing up, and you pick how you want to draw your tree. And I'm using a little bit of brown, everyone, and then also just a little bit of black. And again, we're just going to kind of stroke upwards. You know how much I love to do a little stroking on my paintings. So I've got this brown, I've got this wonderful black. Now, one thing we're going to explore that I love about peace trees, when I was Googling what they might be, and who knows, they're different to everyone, is what grows underneath the ground. So I'm just going to outline my ground with a little bit of green. Let's imagine there's a little bit of grass. Today we're just kind of focusing on lines. So here's a little bit of ground, and here's a little bit of ground. Very simple lines. And now, what you may not know about trees is that they don't grow from the ground. They grow from under the ground. You do have to plant them. And what is under the ground? That is a wonderful question. These wonderful things called roots. So we're going to just draw some roots, and they're often very squiggly lines. So we're going to imagine that this is under the ground. So I'm just going to kind of paint some roots here. Now, if we're thinking of symbolism, rooting down can mean whatever you want. For me, rooting down simply just means building a strong foundation. Now, maybe this is in your painting, maybe it's somewhere else. Now, what you may not know about roots is that they are not clean, but they are swirly. So here's my roots. Rooting for you might be, I don't know, planting a flower. It's up to you. Oh, I've got a very noisy puppy in the background. Here are my roots. We're just kind of filling in. And I'm going to let these dry a little bit. There we go. Just kind of let the music flow through you or whatever you were listening to. So there are our roots. Now, let's fill in my big old trunk here. So I'm going to grab Big Jimmy here. Oh, we're just going to start to kind of create a little bit of texture. Oh, I do love texture. For those of you tuning in, we're working on a tree today, a wonderful tree. Going to focus on symbolism. Sometimes it's very therapeutic times get a little challenging, just to put whatever you're feeling either in music or on the page. Now I'm choosing to do my painting because my lute is in the shop. I do play the lute, although it's been in the shop for quite some time. The shop hasn't been open for quite a while. It may have gotten stolen. Who knows? Going to draw up, and I'm drawing this very wonderful tree. Now I'm going to let Jimmy take a break for a moment. Let's jump on back to Gus. We're going to get some branches going because the peace tree has many different branches. Now I'm going to say that my branches might mean one thing or another thing. There's one branch, let's say. And peace can mean a lot of things. Maybe it means unity. Maybe it just means standing up together. Maybe we're just thinking of a piece of pizza. Who knows? I'm just going to draw a few little branches here. And let's just say they all represent something else. Let's say this one represents, strength. Look at that. And maybe this one represents, courage. Just to assign an idea to whatever you want to. And let's have one grow up. There we go. And maybe there's a couple little things off these. Just a little detail. Who knows? I hope you are all hard at work at home doing something creative, doing something that helps you. Just when things get a little challenging, find a moment. Many thoughts. It's very exciting. We're going to let little one out the door here. All right, little one's back. There you go. She's off. Maybe to do her own art project, I don't know. Okay, so we have created some very wonderful branches here. Now I'm just going to kind of go back in detail because we had some dripping and we can always fix that. There we go. So this is just the beginning of my peace tree, and I think it's turning out rather well. Rather well indeed. So, we're going to let that sit for another moment. And how about we jump on back to Jimmy? Give him a little bit of a workout. I've had such a marvelous sort of weekend just kind of roaming around my yard with my ferrets, and I bought a new guinea pig whose name is Travis. I just love little creatures. I just do. They bring me so much joy, especially when you're not super able to go outside. You can always just kind of hang out with your little creatures. Now what I'm drawing is just a little bit of underground. Now I'm drawing with a little extra brown today because I want to just kind of get the idea that this is underneath instead of in front. So we're gonna just engage a little bit of brown. And then I'll go back with my little brush maybe. And I'm gonna just kind of flesh out. I love that one. Flesh out. For the longest time, I thought it was flush out. I'm not sure where I was corrected, but probably just by, a book or something. Here we go. So, what we're doing is we're just kind of creating a little bit of brown, and what I'm going to do then is just kind of get a sense of these roots. But what I want to make sure we know is that this is in fact underground, because the roots are the base of our tree. It is how the tree grows. You can learn so many wonderful things on Google, and I recommend if there's something you just don't know, just go on the Google. It is so available for you. Now, I should warn you, the internet does indeed cost a little bit of money. But for all the things you can learn, things you don't know, it is, I would say, well worth it. Okay, so there is our just sort of roots. And what I'm loving is the texture, the added texture, but then also the lines. So we have a couple of different techniques going here. We have the roots, right, the squiggly, swirly lines. And then we have that underground sort of dirt, which is creating just the most wonderful texture. And you'll see that it really does look like a root. Now, again, I've never seen a root beyond Google. But again, if you don't know something, look it up. Easy to do. Here we go. All right, there's our little our peace tree. How about that? I think we draw in, maybe just some leaves and things. What I might do, because I'm just so on this idea of different textures, so we're gonna take little Gussie, put him back to work. I'm gonna draw a little bit of leaves. So we're just gonna kind of go around and draw some leaves. Now I'm gonna just do a few of these, and I'll tell you why, because then I'm gonna go back with a little bit of that texture, and I think we'll create what's called a contrast. So we're just gonna kind of draw in a few of these. I'm kind of loving how this is turning out. Now you can do this with markers, absolutely fine. Markers draw very clean lines, and that is why we love them. But watercolor creates movement, and that today is what we are focusing on. And you can just really do this any way you want. Create different shapes of leaves. There are so many different kinds of leaves in the world. For those of you tuning in, it is so wonderful to see you. We are focusing today on symbolism, specifically how it might pertain to a tree. Now, I have chosen to do what I like to call a peace tree, but yours can be whatever you want. Perhaps, I don't know. Perhaps yours is a unity tree, or I don't know, maybe some kind of tree that represents maybe some strength, or who knows. Lots of options. Maybe yours is a love tree. Well, that might be fun. So many options. So I'm just drawing out these little leaves. And I'll tell you what, I might even add in a little detail, because so many different things represent peace to me. Again, I focus a lot on peace because of my large family. We were always trying to seek peace with one another. And it was a very big theme in my household. So, I'm going to focus on that today. But again, your tree can represent whatever you want it to be. Maybe yours is a community tree. Oh, that's a nice idea. So we're just drawing a little bit of leaves. Now I'm doing that very specifically because I'm gonna jump on back with some texture, but we're gonna have a little outline of leaves. And you can do this a couple of different ways. I'm using a thicker side of my little brush here just to kind of create and fill in, which is working out really well. Or you can do thinner lines, completely up to you. Look at that. We're just finishing up there, and it's kind of really nice. Yeah, I got one right there, a little guy. Oh, maybe right there, who knows? There we go. So we've got just a couple of little leaves. Very fun. Your tree does not have to be leafy. What it could be is, I don't know, maybe branchy. It's entirely up to you. Okay, so now I'm gonna jump on over, and I am going to draw a little bit of green, and I think I'm going to pull a little bit of, a lighter green, and then just some brown. Now, my brush should be relatively on the dry side, but there is a little bit of wet, and I'm just going to start to fill in. But what I'm loving is that the leaves are going to stay indeed set apart, and then you'll be able to see a little bit of my branches as well. So here we go, and I'm just going to draw in, but again, you can still sort of see the leaves. This is us playing with a little bit of texture and just a little bit of difference in technique. So we've got a little bit of that sponging. Oh, I love a good sponge. But then we also have the leafing, and those are the proper terms, sponging and leafing. Here we go. And I'm just drawing up. And I'm making this a little bit lighter today than some of my other sponges. We've done indeed some, just very, very tall trees. Maybe some evergreens. But this is gonna be a little bit more sparse because I wanna keep those leaves showing through. We're also focusing indeed on the roots of a tree. Because without roots, without foundation, a tree cannot grow. So here we go. Now again, I've chosen peace to be the theme of my tree. And one thing I've discovered is that there is such a thing as peace lilies. Lilies represent peace. So we're gonna go ahead and maybe give this a moment just to dry. And maybe draw just a little bit of background. I'm gonna jump on back to my tree here momentarily, but I'm gonna wet big old Jimmy, get him nice and soaked. Oh, and then we're gonna maybe just focus a little bit on the background. So I've dried him off, and let's just fill right in. So I'm gonna take a little bit of purple, a little bit of blue, and a little bit of white, why not? And I'm just gonna start to kind of create little things in the back, and I'm gonna keep it rather sparse because I want to keep, oh, I love this color. I want to keep the tree our primary focus. We're just filling in just a little something in the background. So I've got this blue, a little bit of purple, oh, and a little bit of white. I'm just gonna kind of, that's gonna kind of create, I don't know, something in the back. Yeah. I'm very curious to know what your trees might have on them. Trees can represent so many things. It is such a calming structure in nature, on our earth, which is why I love to draw them so much. Because they're just, they represent just such beauty, but also strength. And I think that that is a little bit of something we all need right now. So we're just going to kind of draw and just get a sense of what that might mean on our own paintings. And we're just kind of drawing things and giving this a moment just to kind of set so that I can go ahead and draw a couple of little lilies. And then I have one final detail I wanted to add. I'm just going to kind of draw this. Oh, I love that. And we're just kind of adding things. A little sky, a little something. Keeping it rather sparse because we want the star, of course, to be the tree. So we've let that set a little bit. Now, peace lilies, no idea what color they are, but I thought it might be fun to use a little bit different paint. They may look more like roses, but you know what? Beauty, peace, it's all connected. So let's just draw on a little something here. There's maybe just a little something. Oh, how about that being something? I'm just going to kind of draw out little things, just using different materials to represent a little bit of diversity, but also just a little bit of color, right? I tell you, it's such a colorful world. And I'm just using this because I love the contrast in paint. This isn't exactly paint, but it's darn close. We're just kind of drawing these out. There we go. Wonderful. We're just finishing up here with our tree, and I think it's turning out rather nice. I love the little leaves. I think I might want to incorporate one more here. Sometimes it's okay to step back and just have a look at your paintings. If you feel like you need to add more, you can always jump right back in to add a little bit more. So, we have our peace tree. Now, what could symbolize peace? Let us think about this.
Dear driver,
after a little bit of research, there's an advertisement for the day. During a little bit of research, I discovered that peace is often represented by a dove. So, we are going to jump in and maybe see where we might add a dove. But I think maybe our dove lives, oh, right around there. So, I'm just gonna draw kind of a loose outline. I've never done one before. And it might be sort of an interesting bird, but let's see. There's maybe the head. Head of a dove. And here, and then what I wanna capture are the wings. So I'm going to get a little bit of white and a little bit of black because I want to create a little bit of gray. There we go. Wings. Here's our dove. And then our body is just going to be right here. Hard to see, but you'll be able to see it when I zoom in, I promise. And it'll show very well when it dries. Right, so here's our white and a little bit of black. I'm kind of loving the shading. So here's our dove. Let's just get him sitting right there. And just a little something. There's our dove. And again, it's just about the symbolism, right? My symbol today is peace. You can choose whatever you want. And here are the wings of our dove. Let's make them nice and big. And then let's color him in. Again, it's just a little thing. Sitting there. that's wonderful. Just kind of outlining that. I'm leaving a little bit of that black because it's actually outlining and drawing very nicely. Look at that. Here's the wings. That's our little dove. And we'll zoom in. You'll be able to see him in a moment. I think that turned out really nicely. Let's give him a little eye. Okay, so we have a peace tree today with some red little peace lilies. I don't know if that's exactly the color, but that's okay. A rooted tree, and then I've drawn a dove. Now I want to zoom right in because I want to just look at some of the detail. Here we go, we have our roots, big old tall tree. If you zoom in really closely, you can see our dove, which is representative indeed of peace. And you could, if you wanted just to clarify exactly what your tree symbolizes, you are always welcome to just simply write it out. So what we might do, well, let's grab a little bit of black here. We can just write. Look at that. You can even write something very beautiful. I think we ought to zoom in again. And we've written out the word peace. Up to you, whatever you want to do. Let's get one more zoom in of that dove. There we go. Oh, what a fun idea today. Something that just felt very therapeutic indeed. Something I would recommend that if you are having a hard time with anything happening on the news or in the world, just take a moment and find a way to express yourself in a productive and meaningful way. Maybe it's a painting. Maybe it's something of symbolism. Maybe it's music. We never know. Whatever it is that you can do to help and change whatever is happening, we need you. Let's do it all together. Thank you all so much for joining me. I'm Jean Moss. This is Painting at Home. I will be back again later this week. I invite you, please, just go outside, look around, have a meaningful conversation with someone, and we'll see you back here.